Decimals. Understanding tens. Manu, yesterday you played with such a disc. Using this very disc, I can teach a very important concept of arithmetic. What is that concept? It is called decimals. Look at the disc. In how many equal parts it has been divided? In 10 parts. Let us take out one part out of it. What fraction of the whole disc does this one part represent? 1/10. Here is one strip. It is also divided into 10 equal parts. One part of it is colored red. This colored part also represents 1/10. We write 1/10 also as 0.1. If we take out its two parts, what would these represent? 2/10. We write 2/10 also as 0.2. Here are 10 strips. Each is divided into 10 parts. Look at the color parts of each and the fraction it indicates. If all the 10 parts of the strip are colored, what fraction does it represent? How do we represent it? It is nothing but a whole strip. So, we write it as 1/10. Thus, a part of the whole can be represented in two forms, namely fraction form and a decimal form. In 0.1, the dot is read as a decimal point. How will you write the colored parts of this kind? Can we write it as? Yes. But in this chapter, we shall write it as. Similarly, we shall write. Manu, decimals can also be represented on a number line as mark 0 in the beginning of the line, mark 1, 2, 3 and so on at equal distances. Divide the portion of the line in between 0 and 1 in 10 equal parts. Portion in between 1 and 2 again in 10 equal parts and so on. Manu, you must also learn how to write a decimal in the place value table. You are already familiar with place value table. Place value table was formed creating columns of ones, then of tens, then of hundreds, and then of thousands, that is, from ones column, we moved to the left. For writing the decimal in the place value table, we extend the table to the right by one column. New column is titled as 10th. Decimals like 0.4, 1.2, 0.6, 2.1, 17.4 are inserted in the place value table as